inputting and outputting is great, but what if we wanted to make a decision based on the input that a user gives? There are two decision structures that we will go over. The first is the if-then. The structure of the if is such that if this condition is true, it will do the body of code. If the condition is not true, it will skip over the entire curly brackets and continue on. If we look at this flowchart based on this if structure, we can say x is equal to 3. If x is greater than 0, because that is a true statement, we would follow the right-hand side of this flowchart and execute the code body. If this was a false statement, we would go to the other side and continue on, completely skipping over this code body. There are many variations to the if-then. We could have an if with a condition and then an else. The else is the optional catch-all that will execute if the if condition is not true. If you have an if statement, only the if is required. The else is optional. If your body of code to be executed is only one line, you can also eliminate the curly brackets. If you have more than one line to be executed in the body of code, you need curly brackets around it to keep them together. So the flowchart for the if-else looks like this. If this condition is true, x greater than 0, I will go to the true side and execute the code body. If this condition is false, I will come over to the false side and do code body 2. The last variation is to include the else if. You notice the else if is a hybrid look between the else and the if. We still have our condition in parentheses, we still have our word if, and we still have the keyword else. So we kind of have the best of both worlds. So if condition 1 is true, it will do the body of code at the top. Once it's done executing that body of code, it will find the closed curly bracket for the entire structure and continue on. If condition 1 is false, the structure will go to the second else if and test condition 2. If condition 2 is false, it will go down and test condition 3. If condition 3 is true, it will execute the body of code under condition 3 and exit out of the structure. You can only find one true condition per if-else-if structure. So even if multiple conditions are true, it can only execute one, and it will pick the first one that it finds and exit out. Let's take a look at the flowchart. If x is greater than 10, if that is true, I will do code body 1. If that is false, I will come down and test if x is greater than 7. If that is true, I will do code body 2, and so on. I can only have one true condition per if-else-if structure. So once it finds a true condition, it will exit out. In code, if we said int x is equal to 3, if x is greater than 10, x is greater than 10. Otherwise, I can say if x is greater than 7, I'm going to print x is greater than 7, but less than 10. The only way to get to the second condition is by failing at the first. So the first condition has to be false in order for the second condition to even be checked. If I get to the third condition, that means I can safely say x is greater than 5, but less than 7, because it's not greater than 10, and it's not greater than 7, but it is greater than 5. So if this condition holds true, it will print x is greater than 5, but less than 7. If none of these conditions are true, the else will be the catch-all, and it will print x is less than 5. So back to our game of chips. We have this variable called bool player one turn, and I've initialized it to true. Then we have an array of players' names. So I can add an if statement and say, if player one turn is true, then I want to print player one's name. If player one turn is false, that means it's player two's turn, and I want to print player two's name. Let's give it a try. So after I've determined the total number of chips in my starting pile, I'm going to say, if player one turn is equal to true, I want to print out player 1's turn. So if player 1's turn is true, I'm going to print the player at the first position in my array. Because player one turn is of type Boolean, it's going to evaluate to true or false anyway, therefore eliminating the need for me to compare it to true. It's either going to be true or it's going to be false. So I don't need to say if it's equal to true. I could just say if player one turn. Now I can do the same thing for player two. So now the player whose name is at position one will be prompted to enter how many chips they would like. And then I will give them the prompt of how many chips they can take. And then we will input chips taken from the user. Let's give it a try. So I'm prompted for my name, and now it prompts me with my name, how many chips would you like? Because my chip pile started at 19, I can take up to 9 chips on this turn. If I enter 5, my game does nothing.